You know, Rani, for somebody who was not interested in becoming an actress at all, you know, you did so well for yourself with different kinds of roles. You know, in your early phase, it was a different kind of set of movies. And then you took up very challenging roles like in Black and then now like Hitchki. You did a Mardani in between.
Yes.
You know, and you've like managed to excel in your career, even though you didn't want to be an actress. What is it now in hindsight you feel, what was that quality that kind of got you there or, you know, has retained you there?
See, firstly, I think I was a very obedient daughter. So that helped me listen to my mom and I became an actor. This is quite unheard of in today's time that, you know, a mother or father would tell their child, like, I wouldn't expect that out of my own daughter. Like I wouldn't tell my daughter that do this and she would do it.
Right.
I would want her to pursue something that she would want to pursue, you know, and give her the freedom. But it so happened in my case that my mother wanted me to be an actress and I became one. And then I started enjoying it. And today I actually thank her because I don't see myself as anything else but an actor. I feel I'm born to be an actor. Like the line in my film, I was born to be a teacher. I think I was born to be an actor because I don't think I belong anywhere else but in the movies. But I think what's carried me forward is, I think, the simplicity with which I've tried to handle my stardom. Because normally this industry can give you so much love and adulation. At the same time, snatch it away from you in 1 second. So it's very important to be level-headed, grounded. Understand the fact that the audience loves you for who you are on screen and your persona on screen. And they love your characters. You know, and we shouldn't mistake that to be the love that they have for us as individuals. So it's very important for us to also cut from that zone when we come back home. So we need to lead normal lives to be able to see yourself at a distance and say that, okay, that's my persona on screen and that's for my fans and that's for the media. And this is me, my home, my family, my child, my husband, my parents, my friends. And that's another, that's the real zone. That's the place where I belong first. And this is my workspace. So you need to have a balance, and the only difference in my workspace and probably somebody else's workspace is that my workspace requires me to be seen, requires me to be available all the time to people who watch my work persona. So that's the only difference. You know, so I've always striked that balance. I've done my work and come back home and then completely shut off. And that, I think, keeps me going, keeps me sane, and also the sincerity with which I approach my work.